So here it is named as impregnation or trituration or grounding. Okay, bhavana has a vital role in the processing of rasaushadhis, especially in kalviya rasayanas. So bhavana is the process, helps in the preparation of kalviya rasayanas, and also in bhavana the trituration of the rasadravyas is done with the specific liquids such as jala, swarasa, kwata, taila, dugdha, etc. So here the process is done till the powder attains the dryness. So here bhavana, it not only helps in the removing of the impurities, but also it assists in improving the and enhancing the bioavailability of the drug. Okay. So the definition of bhavana according to Rasatarangini, second chapter, 49th sloka. Yat churnitasya dhatvadev dravaihi sampesya shoshanam bhavanam tanmatam vigner bhavanacha nigatyate. So the reference is Rasatarangini, second chapter, 49th sloka. So here the meaning is bhavana is a procedure or it's a process in which the powdered rasadravyas are triturated with specified liquid media until the liquid dries up or until the powder attains the dryness. So it is considered as one bhavana vidhi. So that is yat churnitasya. Churnitasya means powder. Dhatvader dravaihi. Dhatvadi. Dhatvadi means it may be maharas, uparas, adas, sadhan rasa, or dhatu, or upadhatu. So the powdered rasadravya when triturated with dravadravyas. Okay. Dravaihi sampesha shoshanam. Duration is, it is triturated till it attains the dry. Bhavanam tanmatam vigne. Bhavanacha negati. So there is another shloka for bhavana from Baishaja Ratnavali, 4th chapter, 117th shloka. So here, Diva Diva Atape Shushkam Ratro Ratro Nivasai Shushkam Churni Krutam Dravyam Saptaham Bhavana Vidhi. So here the meaning is bhavana is the process by which powders of drugs are triturated to a soft mass with the liquid specified for particular shodhana and are then allowed to dry under the sun rays in the daytime and are again put into the liquid, same liquid media during the night time. So this process is repeated for 7 days. So here also it is named as bhavana. Reference is Baishaja Ratnavali. So that is diva diva atape shushkam. So after giving bhavana, so here the material is dried under sun rays. Ratro ratro nivasaye. So again, it is the material is put into liquid during the night hours. Shushkam churni krutam. So after the 7 days, when we get the dry powder, so that is considered as bhavana. Dravyam saptaham bhavana vidhihi. Baishaja Ratnavali, 4th chapter, 117th shloka. Okay. So in some other reference, it is stated that so bhavana is a process in which powder substances are kept immersed in liquid overnight. Even that procedure also considered as bhavana. So the best example is kasisa shodhana. So kasisa crystals are kept immersed in vrungaraja swarasa. It's a best example for this third method. So in the third method, so here it doesn't require any trituration at all. Directly the powder rasadravya is kept soaked or kept immersed in rasa dravadravya for whole night. So it's considered, it is also considered as one bhavana. Yeah. And next comes the aims and objectives of the bhavana. So what is the aim and objective of bhavana vidhi? So the first thing is it helps in uniform mixing of the drug. So whenever we are making any sort of churna sandal, it may be sitopaladi, vashtaka and all. So bhavana karma, it helps for uniform mixing of the drugs. And also bhavana helps to reduce the particle size of the material of the rasadravya, helps for the reduction of the particles. Even bhavana assists for the further process also. So before shodha, before marana process, so to prepare chakrika sandal, we need the help of this bhavana vidhi. And even it increases the body acceptance also. So after this bhavana vidhi, so as the metal ions are converted into safe compound, so it will become suitable for internal use. So after giving bhavana with specified liquid media, so it will become suitable for internal use also. Means the drug which is underwent the bhavana process, so which is easily readily absorbable in the body, it will become readily absorbable in the body, and also it increases the bioavailability of the drug, which could be easily get digested and assimilated in the body cells. So these are the benefits of bhavana vidhi. Okay, and even it increases the surface area of the drug. When we start triturating the drug material with the bhavana drava, so it helps to reduce the particle size. Also, it increases the surface area of the drug, so as to more surface area of the drug will come in contact with the bhavana drava. Okay, and also bhavana helps to improve the therapeutic effect of the drug. And also, it helps to give specific shape to the material. For example, before preparation of the vatigutika, so we need to give bhavana with any drava drava, isn't it? For example, in Ananda Bhairava Rasa, Jambira Rasa is used. Afterwards, the material is rolled into pilsh, isn't it? So here, bhavana vidhi also helps to give shape to the material. That is, it can be converted into vatiyat. Gutikas means easily molded in the form of OTR gutikas. Okay, these are the benefits or aims and objectives of the bhavana vidhi. So next comes the method of bhavana vidhi. So in the method of bhavana vidhi, so here it can be studied under three headings. First one is, see, even in the post-graduation examination also, theory exam also, better you present your answer in this way. Okay, so here the first step regarding the method of bhavana vidhi is, so collection of the required materials for the bhavana. First one is instruments required for bhavana. That is, we need kalva yantra, it may be vartulakar kalva, or it may be ardhachandrakara kalva, or it may be tapta kalva. Then we need palika yantra, that is spoon or the spatula. We need patras, we need vastra. Then ingredients required are, so bhavya dravya. So remember, bhavya dravya means that is a rasadravya which requires bhavana. Okay, bhavya dravya is rasadravya. Bhavana dravya is, that is a jala, or it may be soras, or it may be kvata, or it may be gulab jala and all. Okay, then the second step is the quantity of liquid to be taken, the amount of liquid to be added for the bhavana vidhi. So here we need to take the liquid, the quantity of liquid which is enough to make the material wet. Okay, so that is the standard quantity of liquid for the bhavana vidhi. That is, the reference is Rasa Tarangini, second chapter, 50th shloka. Dravena yavatam dravyam churnitam tu ardratam vraje. Tavaneva dravo deyo bishagbihi bhavana vidau. So here meaning is, we need to add the liquid to the powdered rasa dravya in optimum proportion, that it gets sufficient moisture and forms the pulp. Otherwise, till it wets the whole powdered rod, or till it immerse in the powder drug. Till it immerse the powder drug until that that much quantity of liquid to be added for bhavana. So while writing the bhavana vidhi, the quantity of liquid is most important. So if for the bhavana vidhi, if kvata is recommended, for any of the bhavana, if kvata drava is recommended, then also in samhitas, in shastras, we get the clarification that bhavya dravyam iti kvato jalam ashtagunam tatah svavamsham shoshitah kvato deyam kvatena bhavana. So if kvata is mentioned for the bhavana vidhi, so then the kvata is prepared in the proportion of 1:8 ratio. So for one part of the drug, 8 parts of water is added, then it is heated on the gas stove and reduced to 1/8. Okay, this is the method of preparation of kvata if kvata is recommended for bhavana vidhi. So here 1/8 part, it should be reduced to 1/8. Okay, that is jalam ashtagunam. So the quantity of water is also 8. And it is reduced to 1/8. 1:8 and reduced to 1/8. Okay. And the last step in bhavana is the method. First one is collection of requirement. Second one is the proportion of liquid. Third point is the method. The method of operation. So here in bhavana vidhi, the method of operation is all the rasadravyas are collected in kalvayantra and powder. Okay, the first thing is we need to powder the raw drugs in kalvayantra. Second one, sufficient quantity of liquid is added to it. So here sufficient quantity means the liquid which moist the powder or till it moist, till it immerse the raw drug. Third point is slowly it is triturated until all liquid dries up or till the powder attains the dryness. Then the same procedure is repeated for prescribed number of times. So for some bhavanas, 3 bhavanas are quoted. For some, 7 bhavanas are recommended. For some, 21 bhavanas are recommended. So based on specificity, so we have to give that much number of bhavanas. Then finally, the dried product is collected in an airtight container. Yeah. So, in bhavana vidhi, the precautionary measures are, so the required quantity, only the required quantity of liquid to be added. Okay, that is the first precautionary measure. We should not add excess quantity of liquid. Only required quantity of liquid is added to the raw drug. And second thing is, avoid the outfalling of the drug or wastage of the raw drug. Then always while doing bhavana, so I told you, the force, friction and the temperature, it plays a vital role in bhavana vidhi. So that's why always while doing bhavana, we need to maintain the uniform movements. Okay, uniform movements should be followed while giving the bhavana. Then the drugs are triturated till their dryness. Okay, these are the precautionary measures which are taken during bhavana vidhi. And the next comes the siddhi lakshanas. Okay, the indication of proper bhavana, that is subhavita and durbhavita lakshanas. So as quoted in Rasa Tarangini 50 and 51st shloka, subhavita dravya lakshanas are peshamanam cha yad dravyam chipati bhuyah churnatam yati mardava yuktan tat subhavitam udavritam. So after the bhavana vidhi, after the trituration, the paste can be molded in the form of flake. It should be easily molded in the form of flakes, that is a chipati bhuyah, and it is soft in nature. So then only it is considered as subhavita lakshana. So in the same way, durbhavita dravya lakshanas are yat pishtam sahasa dhirnam करस्पर्शनम न कोमलम तत् दुर्भावितम इति उक्तम भावना वेदिभिः जनैः. So in the same way, the durbhavita dravya, where the paste cannot be molded in the form of flakes, so it breaks or it makes the cracks on the surface and it is rough in touch. So based on this subhavita and durbhavita lakshana, so we have to consider the completion of bhavana. Yeah. So these are the three main steps based on which we have to present the answer. So few examples for bhavana vidhi. First one is sasyaka shodhana in jambira rasa. So sasyaka is copper sulfate. Okay, it's a ore of copper, CuSO4, isn't it? 7H2. And bhavana drava dravya is jambira swarasa. So jambira is acidic in reaction, isn't it? So it is a acidic drug, it is a citric acid. So use of jambira nimbu swarasa in sasyaka shodhana, it is nothing but acid base reaction. So the copper ore or the copper, it reacts within reacts in acidic media, that is CuSO4 plus citric acid, it makes the cupric citrate, okay, which can be easily burnt into ash form. Means here the sasyaka, which is given bhavana with jambira rasa, where the further process, that is the, it will assist the marana process, the easy marana process of the sasyaka. So that is the importance of this bhavana drava in sasyaka shodhana. So in the same way, in hingula shodhana, ardraka swarasa is used. So here interpretation is, so the ardraka, it's a bioactive drug. So after giving bhavana with ardraka swarasa to hingula, it increases the bioavailability of the hingula, and also it will make the metal ions to a safe compound. It will make the hingula safe for the internal use. So that is the interpretation for hingula shodhana with ardraka swarasa. Clear? And in the same way, other examples are kasisa shodhana in bhrungaraja swarasa, then gairika shodhana in godugdha, mruddhara shunga in jala, pravala pisti in gulab jala, then abraka basma with kasamarda swarasa. So in consideration with kalviya rasayanas, so the best example is, so as I quoted in previous class also, Smriti Sagara Rasa and Samira Pannaga Rasa. So here in these two preparation, the bhavana drava, it plays an vital role. Okay. See here, if we see the key ingredients of Smriti Sagara Rasa and Samira Pannaga Rasa, so almost all same in nature. Both the combinations are same in nature. But Smriti Sagara Rasa, it acts as medya and used in Unmada, because here bhavana dravas are Vacha, Brahmi and Jyotishmati. So the same combination which is given bhavana with Vacha, Brahmi and Jyotishmati, it acts as medya and indicated in Unmada and Apasmara. For the same combination which, where the bhavana is given with the Tulsi Swarasa, which acts as Vata Shamaka and indicated in Vata Vyadhi, that is Samira Pannaga Rasa. Samira is Vata, Samira Pannaga Rasa is, so here this preparation, it mitigates aggravated Vata, so indicated in Vata Vyadhi, because here Bhavana Drava is Tulsi Swarasa. So here, because of variation in the Bhavana Dravas, so that's what the action of the drug also varies here. Clear? So it's an best example for Kalviya Rasayanas. Clear? So here, the conclusion is, or the inference is, some moisture content of the bhavana dravya may be absorbed. That is, the bhavana dravya transfers their inherent pharmacological properties to the rasa dravya. So that's what, after giving bhavana, the pharmacological actions and the therapeutic action of the drug get increases. Okay. And the second one is some toxic substances which are soluble in bhavana dravya may be removed or neutralized. Okay, so after giving bhavana with some drava dravya, the toxic effects or the toxic compounds which are present in the rasa dravya get neutralized or get removed, eliminated from the rasa dravya. And this bhavana vidhi, it converts the metal ions to a safe compound. So that is also benefit of this bhavana vidhi. And finally, it makes suitable for internal administration, which helps for ready absorption of the drug and also makes the drug bioavailable. So here, the probable changes may be, so the probable or the predictions are maybe, so here the actions may be, reactions may be reduction or it may be liberation. Okay, concerned with the rasa dravyas, when we give bhavana with specific drava dravyas, so the following reaction may occur. It may be reduction process or it may be liberation process, as such the liberation of the sulfur and all gases and all, or it may be oxidation, maybe the action may be because of oxidation process, or here it may be because of neutralization process, or it may be because of salt formation, or it may be because of sublimation process, or it may be because of formation of a complex conjugate. Okay, so because of all these reactions, so these are the probable reactions which may occur during bhavana process. See, these are the just interpretations. So it may occur or may not. So here it may be reduction process, or it may be liberation process, or it may be oxidation, or it may be salt formation or neutralization. These are the few predictions may considered in bhavana vidhi. Clear? So these are the different steps involved in bhavana. Okay, so whenever you are writing